Welcome back to my class, children. Today we are going to see comparison of classical theory and modern theory. So you may be expected this question for one mark question, name some classical economist. Already we learnt about many classical economists. Will you name it? Yes, very good. So the classical economists are Adam Smith, David Ricardo, J.S. Mill, T.R. Malthus or some of the classical economists, leading classical economists. I'll repeat again, Adam Smith, David Ricardo, J.S. Mill, T.R. Malthus or great leading classical economists. So in this theory, international theory, classical theory, we saw about Adam Smith and Ricardo's theory, cost theory, absolute theory and cost theory. So in those theories, the both the authors has explained the country is producing many goods and services which they are more efficient in those production. So if they are not able to produce some other kind of a goods and services, they can import it. Okay, that is what the classical economist view. And modern economist view, we saw it is a factor endowment theory. Many factors we are using here. We use only labor alone, but here we use both the labor and capital. So the labor capital ratio, based on the labor capital ratio, they are producing in modern theory. So now we are going to see the comparison of this classical theory and modern theory of international trade. There are only 3 points to remember. Okay, the classical theory is based on the labor theory of value. Okay, you need not write all these things. Okay, you just write classical theory of trade is based on labor theory of value. But here it is a general theory of value. Okay, labor theory of value, general theory of value. And second point, only one factor we are taken here, that is labor. Here multi-factor model. Okay, one factor model, multi-factor model. And here the comparative cost difference to productive efficiency of workers. Okay, worker odaya efficiency ennaengiradha base panni da and the difference la nam inga production pandrom. But here factor endowment in the two countries. Okay, so you have to write only the 3 points. The first point, labor theory of value, general theory of value, one factor, multi factor, comparative cost to productive efficiency of workers. Here comparative cost to factor endowment in the two countries. Are you clear? So the classical economist view, labor theory of value, general theory, one factor, multi factor. Here it is a productive efficiency of workers and factor endowment in the two countries. Thank you, children. Next class we'll see the remaining concepts.